ॐ सहना भवतु सहनाभुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणम् विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बुद्धिं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्व नित्यं मे निश्चिता मतिः। So the definition of jiva, either kutastha chaitanya chidabhasa along with buddhi or avidya, initially it was mentioned, and the chidabhasa, abhasa or pratibimba, among the three the pratibimba can be of the Brahma Chaitanya or Kutastha Chaitanya. Siddhanta is Brahma Chaitanya because there is no Kutastha Chaitanya separate from Brahma Chaitanya. It is just a name given. And in the example also we saw the Ghatajala has a Pratibimba of Mahakasha, not Ghatakasha. Not Ghatakasha. Therefore, the Pratibimba called as Chidabhasa also is of the Brahma Chaitanya. In the Buddhi, also called as Antakkarana. Or Antakkarana, in which Buddhi specifically, because it is the Upalabdhisthana. Now, the second Paksha is taken. We see this. Before that, let's look at the Tippana. There is a Tippana there. I didn't cover the Tippanas. Before we move on to the other Paksha of Avidya. Avidya being the Upadhi for Jiva. For Chaitanya to become Jiva. Let's look at the... we saw the first Tippana. Second was... here. Buddhi Rupa Ghata. So, Kama Karmatmaka Jalapurita Buddhi Rupa Ghataha. There we have to see the Tippana. And the third one is on Kutastha. Kutastha to Sarva Vikara Shunya. That's the third Tippana. So, second Tippana on the Kama Karmatmaka Tatha Kama Karmatmaka Jalapurita Buddhi Rupa Ghata Punya Papadi Sakala Vikriya Ashraya Bhavati Kutastha to Sarva Vikara Shunya. Kutastha is free from Vikaras. Vikaras are in the buddhi, which is a for which the placeholder is ghata. Kama karmatmaka buddhi in the exemplified, in the example, jalapurita ghataha. So ghata is the placeholder for buddhi. While ghata holds jala, the buddhi holds kama karma ityadi. Thereby vikaras are in the buddhi, they are not in the Atma, in the Kutastha Chaitanya. So Tippadakara says, Vastutastu Sukadukhadi Samsaro na Buddhirapi Sambhavati. Earlier we saw the combination of the three, meaning the triad is Jiva. In that Kutastha Chaitanya does not have Vikaras. Who has the Vikaras? Buddhireva. So initially we saw this. All is punya papa tatphala sukha dukha lokantara gamana agamanadi sarvam buddhireva natu chidabhasasyapi. We took it away from kutastha chaitanya, all the vikaras, then we took it away from chidabhasa also. What is left is buddhi. In the triad, these are buddhi dharmas. Now, interestingly, see, this is what anirvachani. To understand what is mithyatvam, what is anirvachaniyatvam, you have to understand this. Chaitanya does not have vikara. Who has the vikara? Okay, Chidabhasa has vikara. No, Chidabhasa cannot have vikara because Chidabhasa is an abhasa, a pratibimba of Chaitanya. Independently, it cannot have any vikara. Oh, okay, then guna guneshu vartante. Buddhi has vikaras. Okay, buddhi has vikara. We have settled down. But the tippanakara says, Vastutastu sukadukhadi samsarahana buddhirapi sambhavati. They are not buddhi dharmas also really. That is why anirvachaniyatvam. It is not just that the prapancha is there. All the prapancha gata gunas are there, dharmas are there, and they appear in me. Really they aren't there. So if we say there are dharmas outside, gunas outside, kama, karma, ityadi, punya, papa, all that is really existent. They appear in me by bhranti. That is true, but not they appear in me due to bhranti is true, but they exist elsewhere, really exist is also bhranti. Therefore, vastutastu sukadukhadi samsarana buddhirapi sambhavati. Sukadukha is not there in buddhi also. Vastuta, in reality, this is a keyword there, vastutaha. Tathacha uktam guhadikarana bhashye brahma sutra. In brahma sutra, there is an adhikarana, guhadikarana. There in the bhashya, Bhagavan bhashyakara says, idam hi kartrutvam bhoktrutvamcha sattva kshetrajnayor itaretara swabhava avyveka krutam kalpyate. So, idam hi kartrutvam bhoktrutvam, which is going to lead to bhoga of sukha dukha. Kartrutva will lead to bhoktrutva. And bhoktrutva is of what? Bhoga of sukha dukha. Ityadi samsara. That is samsaranam. That is why a person continues in samsara. And what does he say? Idam hi kartrutvam bhoktrutvamcha sattva. Sattva is antakkarana buddhi. Kshetrajna. So, kshetra kshetrajna. Instead of saying kshetra, Bhagavan Bhashyakara is saying sattva. Sattva is another way to say antakkarana or buddhi. Sattva kshetra jnayoho itaretara swabhava aviveka krutam kalpyate. So far, we have already studied that kshetra jnaya or kutastha chaitanya has no vikaras. Sattva has vikaras. And due to aviveka between sattva or kshetra or antakkarana or buddhi, anatma and atma kshetrajna kutastha brahma chaitanya chit chidatma, these are due to aviveka between the two, their dharmas are superimposed on each other, which is called as adhyasa. This much we have seen in the mula also. Now, itaretara swabhava avyuveka krutam, we have seen, kalpyate. Paramarthatastu. Now, kalpyate, when you say, then paramarthatastu, meaning vastuta, what is it in reality? Paramarthatastu na anyatarasyapi sambhavati. They are superimposed on each other. Now, if you separate them out cognitively and analyze, can they independently have samsara, kartrutva bhoktrutva rupa sukha dukkhadi samsara? Is it possible? Can sattva kshetra have it? Sharira, sukshma sharira beat. Can kshetrajna have it? Kshetrajna having samsara has been refuted. Can kshetra have it? Na anyatarasyapi. If you pick any of the two independently, it is not possible. Achetanatvat sattvasya. Sattva, kshetra or antakkarana is achetana. Achetana cannot have any karya. Kartrutva is not possible. Definitely bhoktrutva is not possible. Padmanabhanji, kindly switch off the video. I do not mind who does what during the class, but kindly switch off the video. Otherwise, I will block the people. It is irritating to see people doing anything and everything during the class. At least have the respect of not doing it. Switch it off. That's it. You do whatever you want, but please switch off during the class. We don't want to see what people are doing during the class other than the class activity. I prefer not to see that. I keep it because if someone has a question, I keep this page open. I prefer not to see I am okay with you doing whatever you want because Swatantra Karta, you can decide what is best for you, each one of you. But please do not showcase to others that I prefer to do all the puja karya. Vedanta is on the sidelines. Idam hi kartrutvam bhoktrutvam cha sattva kshetrajnyoho itaretara swabhava aviveka krutam. You are free to open the video also, but I would like to see you sitting in front and paying attention, not roaming around. That is the idea, nothing else. It puts the class off. I cannot focus on the teaching then. So paramarthatastu na anyatarasya api sambhavati. Why? Ye achetanatva. Achetana cannot do anything. Sattva is, kshetra is achetana. Okay, then let chetana, kshetrajnya have samsara. That is not possible. Why? Avikriyatvacha kshetrajnyasya. The kshetra can have vikara, sattva, antakkarana can have vikara, vikari antakkaranam. However, chetana is lacking. On the other side, you have undi chetana, vikara is lacking. So independently, they cannot have any karya. Thereby, anyatarasyapi samsara na sambhavati. Only when that mix-up is there, then only samsara is possible. Then only this bhranti of kartrutva bhoktrutva is also possible. Vikara is possible, karya is possible. Avidya pratyupasthapita swabhavatvacha sattvasya sutaramna sambhavati. Impossible. That's what is sutaramna sambhavati. Avidya pratyupasthapita swabhavatvacha. Another hetu is given. Sattva cannot have samsara, meaning antakkarana buddhi by itself also cannot have any of these samsara dharmas because it is a karya of avidya. Avidya itself is mithya. So sutaram na sambhavati tatha cha shruti, and that is what the shruti says. This dvaita prapancha is not real. There is nothing outside of Chaitanya. And samsara will continue as long as one imagines that this samsara is in me, sukha dukkhadi are in me. This is the tattva drishti prashna. Prashna is, maybe it is not in me, but I do have a bhranti. How do I take it away? By jnana, that it is not only in, not in you, it is not elsewhere also. Because samsara, jiva, ishvara, any of this being separate from you and really existent means dvaita. Then only anyaha anyat pashyati. So that is covered up in the quotation of the Shruti. Tathacha Shruti in the Bhashya there itself. Yatra vanyat divasya tatra anyo anyat pashyet. So anyad ivasyat, iva, ivakara is added there. As though another is there. There is no another. But even if there is as though another, yatra, syat tatra anyaha anyat pashyet. Anyaha anyat. All the cognitions are possible only when there is another. And that is also iva. Yatra va anyad diva. Syat tatra anyo anyat pashyet. Anyaha anyat anyo anyat shrunoti also. So every possibility is with vidhiling. Of course it should be vidhiling. Ityadina swapna drishta hastyadi vyavaharavat avidya visheyeva kartrutvadi vyavaharam darshayati. So Shruti shows what? Shruti shows that it is swapnavat mithya. Svapna drishta hasti. There is an elephant in the swapna. Is it real? It isn't real. But swapna drishta hastyadi vyavaharavat. There is a vyavahara in the swapna. Similarly, there is vyavahara in waking. The utility is there in swapna also. The fear is there in swapna also. The greed is there in swapna also. Everything is possible in swapna as much as it is possible in waking. There is no difference. Avidya vishaya. Swapna is avidya vishaya. So is samsara. The waking world also is अविद्या विषय एव कर्तृत्वादि व्यवहारं दर्शयति. देयर आल्सो यू हैव कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व इन स्वप्न, हियर आल्सो यू हैव कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व इन वेकिंग. यत्रत्वस्य सर्वम आत्मैव अभूत्. ऑन द फ्लिप साइड व्हेन ज्ञान टेक्स प्लेस ऑन ज्ञानोदय यत्रत्वस्य सर्वम आत्मैव अभूत् तत्केन कं पश्येत्, तत्केन कं पश्येत्, यूजिंग व्हाट मीन्स विल वन सी अनदर. देयर इज नो कारक भेदा लेफ्ट एट ऑल. That is Advaita Siddhi. There is no karma outside. There is no karta separate. There is no karana separate. And other karakas also. But this is the triad which we call as Triputi. So what means will you use to see what? There is no different. There is nothing different from you as an object. And you don't need a means, even if there were to be. There is no means also. So karanas are also not there. All the indriyas are also not separate from you. There is no reality to the indriyas or the indriya vishayas. Ityadinacha vivekinah kartrutvadi vyavahara bhav darsheti. So vivekinah, one who is a viveki. Here viveki is a jnani really there. कर्तृत्वादि व्यवहार अभाव दर्शयति. सो शोज दैट देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ व्यवहार सच एज कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व इत्यादि. देन कूटस्थस्य, हियर इट वाज सेज कूटस्थ, कूटस्थ या कूटस्थस्तु सर्व विकार शून्य. ऑन दैट स्वामी सेज, सो भगवान टिप्पणकार सेज यथा चंद्रस्य स्वतः निर्विकारतया सदैक रूपत्वेपि तिथिपक्षाभ्याम चंद्रस्य कलानामेव वृद्धिक्षयादिकं भवति यथा वा सदा वृक्षस्य एकरूपत्वेपि तत् फलादीनाम एव जन्मादि विकारो जायते तथा. सो गिव्स टू एग्जांपल्स फॉर दिस निर्विकारत्व ऑफ कूटस्थ. कूटस्थ वी हैव सीन द डेफिनेशन आल्सो. बाय डेफिनेशन इट इज वन डेफिनेशन वी हैव सीन, कूटवत् तिष्ठति इति कूटस्थः, देयर बाय अविकारी. However, here Chandrasya, example given is Chandra. Chandra does not have parts really. Kala, we say today is Chaturdashi, Amavasya, Prathama Tithi, then Pakshas also we see. Shukla Paksha, Krishna Paksha. Based on that, you have waning or waxing moon. The size of the moon varies. Does the size of the moon really vary? The moon is the same. So, Yatha Chandrasya Svataha Nirvikarataya, सदा एक रूपत्वेपि, ही इज ऑलवेज द सेम. ही हैज इन बिकॉज चंद्र इज मैस्कुलिन इन संस्कृत, बट इन इंग्लिश विल से इट इज द सेम. द मून इज द सेम ऑल द वाइल, स्टिल सदा एक रूपत्वेपि तिथि पक्षाभ्याम, बेस्ड ऑन द डे एंड द फोर्टनाइट. चंद्रस्य कलानामेव वृद्धि क्षयादिकं भवति. सो द कलास आर चेंजिंग. Really, they are not Chandra's parts really. But Chandra appears to be changing in size. Similarly, Kutastha Chaitanya appears to mimic. It's a bhranti. Appears. That's why appears. Iva. Yatha va sada vrukshasya ekarupatvyapi. So this is a, you know, seems like a, not an easy example to see. But anyway, vruksha is one. Vruksha does not keep on undergoing janma and marana continuously. But what happens? Tatphaladinameva janmadivikara jayate. The vriksha phalas keep on coming up. You know, phalas as in the seed has already fructified into a vriksha. Now this vriksha remains for many years, but every season you have flowering and fruition. So that fruit comes up and goes every season or every year, annual, whatever, harvest season. So there you have the phalas, but the vruksha remains same. Not necessarily harvest season, whatever is, you know, the season for mango has a season, jackfruit has a season. Similarly, seasonal fruits, for example, or even if you take coconut also, throughout the year you do have it, but still the vruksha remains the same, eka rupatvyapi. But still, the parts come and go. Now, the parts of the jiva are changing, whereas kutastha chaitanya, which is the real swarupa, Now Vruksha will have Phala also. Phala changing, the Vruksha does not really change. In the example, the change is there because Vruksha, the Phala are connected. It's a storehouse for the Vruksha really. Vruksha stores everything. Every vegetable and fruit is the nutrition of the tree for the tree stored. And then it overproduces. It can survive with limited resources. So it gives to the mankind, or rather we take it. And then if it is, you know, the fruit starts to rot, it drops off on its own. When it is overripe, it drops off. It sheds because it can remain without these angas. They are not really angas. Otherwise, there would be trouble when the fruit drops off. It has nothing to do with it beyond that storage value of nutrition. If it doesn't need it, it would shed it. Similarly, the jiva, who is really kutastha, he does not need anything for bhoga. Does not have any nutrition value there. I don't need anything from the samsara. Samsara does not give me this so-called nutrition of sukha ityadi. Sukha dukha di bhoga, I do not need. Then I shed the body. Cognitively initially, and then videha mukti. That is the example there, really. The parts that make up the jiva can be dropped when one doesn't need anything from the parts. Then they are not really your parts because you can drop them like the fruits are dropped. Tatha swayam nirvikarepi kutastha chinmatre pratyagatmani dehadinam eva janmadi shadvikara rupa parinamo jayate tat yadi kutastha eva parinamet. So here, tatha swayam nirvikarepi, even if the, like the vriksha is eka, similarly, or the chandra is eka, whose kalas undergo change, but chandra remains unaffected, vriksha remains unaffected, even when phala comes and drops off. Similarly, nirvikara chin, kutastha chinmatra, only chinmatra, kutastha chaitanya without the upadis, in that kind of a, so swayam nirvikare api kutastha chinmatre pratyagatmani, which is pratyagatma dehadi nameva, which is the upadi it has associated with, all those dehadi nam eva janmadi shadvikara rupa parinamo jayate, there alone all the vikaras are there. Yadi kutastha eva parinamet tarhi sa jadasyat. If kutastha also underwent change, it would be jada, because yatra yatra parinamaha tatra tatra jadatvam, that is a vyapti. We have seen, as in wherever we have seen changes, those changes are in jada. If you see, oh, sentient being is changing. Yes, sentient being is changing is a bhranti. The sentient is really chit. Chit cannot be objectified. What you objectify is sharira. The throbbing in the sharira, the prana movement in the sharira tells you that the person is alive, and the changes in the sharira are seen, not the chaitanya. Parinama is vikaraha. Prakriti anyata abhavaha. Prakriti karana changing into karya is called as vikara or parinama. Tasmat kutastasya vikaro na kathanchana upapadyate. Therefore, kutastha changing in any way is not tenable. So with that background, let's go to 183 now. This is the other paksha. So one part is closed, where jiva definition includes antakarana or buddhi as the upadhi in the triad. Now, who is the jiva really? Ajnana pratibimba chaitanyam jivaha. This is the other paksha, and this is more closer to Siddhanta. Closer to Siddhanta. Why so? Prag ukta jiva swarupe angi kriyamane prajnyasya hani rupajayate. Because in the earlier paksha, where antakkarana or buddhi is the upadi for jiva, there is a dosha. What is a dosha? There cannot be prajnya anymore. Who is prajnya? Prajnya is the sushupti abhimani jiva. The जागृत अवस्था अभिमानी इज कॉल्ड एज विश्व, सेम जीवा इज कॉल्ड एज विश्व वैश्वानर एट द समष्टि लेवल विराट। देन स्वप्न अभिमानी, स्वप्न अवस्था अभिमानी, स्वप्न शरीर अभिमानी इज एट द इंडिविजुअल लेवल कॉल्ड एज तैजस, एट द समष्टि लेवल कॉल्ड एज हिरण्यगर्भ। देन सुषुप्ति अभिमानी वेर देर इज ओनली आनंदमय कोश विच इज वॉट, आनंदमय कोश इज अविद्या अज्ञान रियली, दैट अज्ञान और आनंदमय कोश सुषुप्ति अवस्था अभिमानी इज हु इज दि प्राज्ञ, गेट्स द नेम ऑफ प्राज्ञ एट दि समष्टि लेवल कॉल्ड एज अंतर्यामी, अंतर्यामी अदरवाइज ईश्वर। But people have trouble to say, you know, Ishwara and Prajna are equated. How can Ishwara be with the Ajnana Upadhi? So we say, okay, Maya Upadhi then. And prefer to call it as Antaryami. But the fact is, Ishwara is not Shuddha Chaitanya because he is associated with Maya. Whether he is affected by Maya or not is irrelevant. He has a role to play. If he has a role to play in any upadhi, then that is not the goal of moksha. Otherwise, other dvaitins will also get moksha by knowing such Ishwara, becoming one, or however they have their different types of mokshas. They are anitya, anitya moksha. What we want is beyond the jiva and Ishwara, which is beyond in the sense which is pervading the jiva and Ishwara. That is our swarupa. We have to know that swarupa. That is Turiya. Turiya in the sense the fourth in comparison to the other three, but not really the fourth. It is that which makes the fourth quarter as though makes the whole in a coin. Three quarters are incomplete without the fourth quarter. In that sense, the Turiya word is used in comparison to the earlier three, which is all Bhranti Gata or Bhranti Karya. It is a Brahma. All these namings, divisions, all these are Brahma. Anyat, Anyadiva. But the fourth makes it complete, and once it's complete, you can drop the word Turiya because there is no four, there is only one na, ek, Aikya Siddhi. Anyway, but when we are discussing at the Vyavahara level, definition of Jiva, who is Ishwarad Bhinna initially, that time we have to talk about the possibilities of the entire setup has to be explained. The possibility of the setup means the entire setup including the avasthas have to be explained. Will the jiva definition survive in Sushupti? It won't if you take buddhi or antakarna. Why? Because buddhi is folded, and since there is no jiva active there per se, which is not an issue because we say the Upanishad itself says that there raja na bhavati, where there is no difference between a king and a beggar, between a mosquito and a tiger, between a human and anyone else. There is no division at all in Sushupti, so we don't have an issue there. But jiva has to be explained, so it is preferable to say ajnana is the upadhi instead of buddhi, because buddhi isn't there not as shunya but unmanifest. Otherwise we have to say jiva exists the way one does in when there is laya also, meaning pralaya. In pralaya we don't take the independent jiva the way he was there earlier. That kind of jiva does not continue. Some other jiva comes out, which is also okay again. We can say like Nitya Pralaya and Sushupti. However, what is said here is Pragukta Jiva Swarupe Angi Kriyamane Prajnasya Hani Rupajayate Sati Saptami. When you accept the jiva as defined earlier with buddhi in the triad or antakarana in the triad, then what happens? Tatahi, what is explained? Sushupti Sushuptyabhimaninah Jeevasya Prajna iti nama. Who is Prajna? Sushupti Abhimani. सुषुप्तौ बुद्धे अभावात्, अभाव हियर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट इज अनमैनिफेस्ट बट इट इज देयर बिकॉज वी सी द सेम बुद्धि कम्स अप अगेन. प्रत्यभिज्ञा इज देयर, देयरफॉर बुद्धि अभाव हियर इज ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ थिंकिंग ड्यूरिंग सुषुप्ति बट इट इज देयर वी नो बाय रिकलेक्शन. We knew nothing. So there is a recollection that we objectified some darkness. That darkness cannot be really said to be buddhi, but there is some object there. That is called as ajnana now. Shushupto buddhi abhavat tatsta chidabhasa apina siddhyati. You cannot establish, you cannot argue chidabhasa is there. Why? Because buddhi abhava is there. If buddhi abhava is there, then chidabhasa needs buddhi to be there to come up. Chaitanya is always there. If buddhi isn't there, then how will chidabhasa or pratibimba be there? Na siddhyati tatascha prajna swarupa pratipadaka shastram nirvishayam bhavet. Then the Mandukya Upanishad, which elaborately talks about prajna, or other Upanishads also, what will happen will become nirvishayam. Which prajna will they be talking about? There is no prajna because chidabhasa isn't there. One, chidabhasa and buddhi both are not there. Just kutastha chaitanya cannot be prajna. Ataha prakarantarena jiva swarupa nirupanam kriyate. Therefore, with another methodology, jiva is explained. Another way to explain jiva. Ajnanasya ekadesha vyashti ajnanam miti. संपूर्ण अज्ञानम तु समष्टि अज्ञानम इति च उच्यते. सो देयर इज एन इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड अज्ञान एंड देयर इज टोटल अज्ञान. तत्र अज्ञान एकदेश प्रतिबिंब प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभास. तत्र अज्ञान एकदेश एन इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड अज्ञान इन दैट देयर इज अ प्रतिबिंब. सो प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभास देन तद अज्ञान अंश अधिष्ठाभूत अधिष्ठान अधिष्ठान भूत कूटस्थ चैतन्यं च मिलित्वा जीवैत्युच्यते. सो लाइक अर्लियर डेफिनेशन यू रिप्लेस द अंतकरण और बुद्धि विद अज्ञान इंडिविजुअलाइज एकदेश एंड देयर बाय यू गेट जीव मिलित्वा. न च एतस्मिन् जीवस्वरूपे प्राज्ञस्य अभाव संभवति. एंड हियर Prajna is valid, a valid definition. Why? Because ajnana is there even in Sushupti. In fact, ajnana is clearly known to be existent in Sushupti after one wakes up, of course. One can gather that I did not know anything. That is ajnana. So, tad ajnana ausha adhishthana bhuta kutastha chaitanyam cha militva jiva ityuchyate. न चे एतस्मिन् जीव स्वरूपे प्राज्ञस्य अभाव संभवति सुषुप्तौ अज्ञानस्य सत्वात्. बिकॉज सुषुप्ति हैज अज्ञान. ड्यूरिंग सुषुप्ति वन हैज अज्ञान. इट कंटिन्यूज टू बी देयर. अदरवाइज वन वुड वेक अप एज अ मुक्त. ओनली अ मुक्त वेक्स अप एज मुक्त बट एन अज्ञानी वेक्स अप एज अज्ञानी बिकॉज अज्ञान कंटिन्यूज टू बी देयर इन सुषुप्ति. सुषुप्तौ यश्चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब विशिष्टाज्ञानांशः स बुद्ध्यात्मना परिणमते. एंड द सेम अज्ञान इंडिविजुअलाइज विच इज एग्जिस्टेंट इन सुषुप्ति ऑल्सो दैट मैनिफेस्ट ट्रांसफॉर्म इट्सेल्फ नॉट कंप्लीटली ऑफ कोर्स प्रेजेंट्स इट्सेल्फ एज द कार्य विच इज बुद्धि बिकॉज इट इज अ कारण शरीर. अज्ञान इज कारण शरीर which manifests or which is karana for what? Karana for two shariras, stula sharira and sukshma sharira. So buddhyatmana parinamate in swapna as well as in jagrata avastha. Tatra chaitanya pratibimbha api saha eva vartate. And chaitanya pratibimba being there called as chidabhasa reflecting in ajnana. Therefore in shushupti also Chaitanya Pratibimba is there, and when the Ajnana modifies into Buddhi, called as Sukshma Sharira, then Chaitanya Pratibimba, which was there in Ajnana, will also be there in the Karya. It will continue. There will be Anuvritti. Anuvritti of Chidabhasa will be there in Buddhi also, विथ अज्ञान कारण हैविंग चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब सो इट्स कार्य बुद्धि विल आल्सो हैव अनुवृत्ति ऑफ चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब अस्याम चिदाभास युक्तायाम बुद्धौ पुण्य पुण्यादि रूप संसार प्रतीयते इन दिस बुद्धि देयर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ पुण्य पुण्य एंड अपुण्य पुण्य अपुण्यादि मीन्स पुण्य पाप पुण्य पापादि रूप संसार प्रतीति इज देयर इन दैट बुद्धि विच इज एंडोर्ड विथ चिदाभास Where chit is there, abhasa is there, and buddhi is also there. So, all triad, but in the triad, in the buddhi, there is punya and apunya, adi samsara. Pratiti, pratiti is there. Anena abhiprayana buddhi reva shastreshubi kvachit jiva upaditaya varnyate. So, wherever, in any prakrana grantha or any shastra, even in Upanishad, when Buddhi is mentioned as a part of Jiva. What is really meant as Buddhi, which is Karya of Ajnana, where Ajnana is the component, the third component other than Kutastha Chaitanya and the Chidabhasa. Where is the Chidabhasa really coming up? In the Ajnana, not in Buddhi. In Buddhi, there is a manifestation, and when Buddhi is said to be the third, really what is meant is Buddhi as Karya of Ajnana, Ajnana is the third component. Anena avipraena Buddhi reva shastreshu abhi kvachit jiva upaditaya varnyate. It is not that Buddhi is the upadhi, real upadhi is Ajnana. Buddhi has an anuruti of Ajnana, therefore. It has a ajnana, it is a karya of ajnana, parinama of ajnana, therefore there is an anurti of chidabhasa. Vichara drushtyatu, jivasya upadhi ajnanam eva. What is the real upadhi for jiva? Ajnana. And that is why on the samashti level, you have samashti ajnana called as maya, as an upadhi for jiva. For Ishvara, sorry. Ishvara Swarupa Varnanam. Who is Ishvara then? Ishvara Swarupam tu Bahuda Anekaihi Varnyate. Now there is a long discussion. This we'll look at later because in each Matha, I'll just quickly go through this. Who is Ishvara as per each Matha? We'll have a look at it in the next Patha. Right now we'll look at ईश्वर स्वरूप वर्णनम मायायां प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभासः मायायां प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभासः माया अधिष्ठान चैतन्यं च इति उभयं मिलित्वा ईश्वर इति उच्यते सो समष्टि अज्ञान विच इज माया देन माया अधिष्ठान चैतन्यं विच इज ब्रह्म चैतन्यं च इति उभयं मिलित्वा ईश्वर इत उच्यते सो हियर मायायां प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभास सो माया इज देयर देन ओनली प्रतिबिंब चिदाभास इज पॉसिबल चिदाभास प्रतिबिंब इज पॉसिबल एंड देन माया अधिष्ठान चैतन्य विच इज ब्रह्म चैतन्य उभयम व्हेन यू से उभयम माया इज इंक्लूडेड देयर बिकॉज प्रतिबिंबित चैतन्य Chidabhasa is possible only when Maya is there, which is the Upadhi. So, Ubhaya means the triad really. Militva Ishvara ityuchyate Ayancha Ishvara Megha Kasha Tulya Bhavati. In the example, the cloud space, the space taken by the cloud and the space reflected. What is that space taken by the Megha Kasha? Is not the space, not only the space taken by the cloud, but along with there is a space which is reflected in the jala which is there in the megha. Ayam eva antaryami ityuchyate. So it's a placeholder for this antaryami who is Ishvara really. Antaryami iti kutra uchyate. Mandukya Upanishad. In Mandukya Upanishad, it is called as this Ishvara has been called by the term antaryami. Why? What is antaryami? Sarvesham antastasan niyantrutvat prerakatvat antaryami. He's a controller, inner controller. If you literally translate inner control, what is inner control? Stays within and controls. Sarvesham antastasan antetishtati. Antatishtati, antartishtati. So stays within. And staying within niyantrutvat. He's a controller. And what is this niyantrana that he is doing? What is that niyantrana? Niyantrana is basically prerakatvam. Just staying there, lending satta and spurti, letting them do what they do. Whatever they do is because of the chaitanya. They gain the satta and spurti. Everything gains the satta and spurti due to chaitanya presence. So prerakatvad antaryami. I am nitya muktaha. This Ishvara or antaryami is nitya mukta, always free. Swaswarupavaraka ajnana bhavat tasya. Why is he nitya mukta? Because his swarupa is not lost on him. Avarana is not possible. Ata eva janma maranadi bandha pratiti rasya nasti. Therefore Ishvara does not have pratiti, even a pratiti of janma maranadi. Tata eva Ishvara nitya mukta ityuchyate. That is why Ishvara or antaryami is called as nitya mukta. Kincha Ishvara sarvajnya sarvam janati iti sarvajnya, knows everything. Otherwise he could not have created this prapancha. If he created this vast prapancha, before creating the prapancha, you know, need to have jnana of prapancha. Just like ghatakara needs the jnana of how to create ghata before he creates the ghata. It's not an accidental creation. It is a meticulous creation. Just like any small produce also needs jnana. Jnana purvaka eva shrishti. Therefore, he creates everything. Sarvakrit. He is a sarvakarta. Being sarvakarta, he has created jagatkarta. Therefore, sarva. Jagat is sarvam. Idam sarvam. Therefore, he is the creator, jagatkarta. Therefore, that jagatkarta, being sarvakarta, has to be sarvajnya. Kincha Ishvara sarvajnya. Tasya upadibhuta mayayaha shuddha sattva guna pradhanatvad asya sarvajnyatva siddhihi. And how is he able to be sarvajnya really? He is nirguna. How can you say sarvajnya? Sarvajnyatvam will become a guna. How can nirguna brahma be sarvajnya? No, he has an upadhi of maya. Therefore, upadhi bhuta maya yaha tasya ishwarasya. What happens? Antaryaminaha. What happens? Shuddha sattva guna pradhanatva. The maya at the samashti level, what is called as the ajnana at the samashti level is called as maya. That is shuddha sattva pradhana. It's an effect of, it's a, basically the guna in maya, there is shuddha sattva, which becomes the upadhi for Ishvara. Therefore, sarvajnyatvam. Even if you, incidentally, in Gita, we are looking at this 14th chapter. In 14th chapter, Guna and Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga. Chapter is called Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga. What is each and every Guna? What is its Karya? We were just looking at it yesterday. There, Shuddha Sattva is what? Sattva. Sattva Guna is what? Sattva, Rajas and Tamas are these three Gunas. This Sattva being Pradhana brings up Jnana, which leads to Sukha. Sukha Karaka. So Sukha, Sukhe Sanjayati. By Jnanena Sukhe Sanjayati. Sattvam. So Sattva comes up and then makes Jnana possible. Jnana leads to Sukha. At the highest stage, the Brahma Jnana leads to Atyanta, Atyantika Sukha. You can extend that. But then Sattva makes jnana possible. Now, if sattva is so shuddha, that the sattva is antakkarana also. It becomes, maya becomes an antakkarana, upadhi, manas, manaha for Ishvara. Then it is sattva guna pradhana. Also, that's why manaha is called a sattva. Antakkarana is called a sattva. Buddhi also is called a sattva. Because sattva is the karana for it, sadguna. However, here sattva guna pradhanatva. And what kind of sattva guna here? In the manas is also, individual mind is also sattva guna karya. However, shuddha sattva, there is milita sattva. There is some melan of something else. Tamas and rajas have mixed up a little. Mixed up in a sense, here in maya, the other two gunas are there, but they have not mixed up in that sense to taint the sattva. But in the jiva, there is tainting. Not a little, there is a lot of tainting really. That's why the jiva goes through phases throughout the day and night. Goes to sleep when tamas is pradhana. To wake up, also to get off the bed, one needs some rajas. Then that rajas has to increase for one to continue through the day and not fall asleep. And rajas, when it is continuing, it has to be controlled to sattva and tuned towards dharma karya. Otherwise, that rajas will create havoc. But on the maya side, shuddha sattva being pradhana, not only jnana is possible, but sarvajnana is possible. Therefore, sarvajnyatva siddhihi. Svapratibandhaki bhuta rajastamasi abhibhuya. Swayam tabhyam anabhibhuto yas sattva gunaha tasya shuddha sattvam iti akhya. What is shuddha sattva? Shuddha sattva, sattva is sattva. But why do you call it shuddha sattva? Sattva is really shuddha itself. Why do you call it a shuddha sattva? Shuddha sattva is a name given to sattva guna itself. What kind of sattva guna? That sattva guna which is svapratibandhaki bhuta rajastamasi abhibhuya. That sattva which having overpowered, this abhibhuya is levanta, replacement for tva pratyaya. So having overpowered, abhi is there. So abhipurvaka bhudhatu plus tva, tva will be replaced by ya when abhi is there. There is an upasarga, when it is there, which is other than nanj, then that time tva is replaced by lyap. Has the same meaning as tva. Having abhi is abhita, completely overpowered rajas and tamas. Rajas tamas e is a dual. Svaprata pratibhandaki bhuta. Rajas and tamas will not let you to know your swarupa. Tamas will hide your swarupa, rajas will project. Rajas will cause vikshepa, tamas causes avarna. So both are Svaprata pratibandhaki bhuta, rajas and tamas, having overpowered that, the sattva overpowers, when it becomes powerful, it overpowers the tamas and rajas. Then what will happen? Swayam tabhyam anabhibhutaha yaha, not at all affected by the presence of rajas and tamas, which are there, but not affected at all, because it is so powerful, they are just lying around, that's all. Yaha sattva guna, that sattva guna has a name as shuddha sattva. Sattva guna deva jnana utpadyati. And due to sattva guna, jnana comes up. And then if it is shuddha sattva, then sarva jnana. Atha sattva guna prakasha svabhavaha. Also called, sattva guna is called as being prakasha svabhava. Why? Because due to sattva, when sattva is more, jnana is possible. Jnana is revealing something which is prior unknown or hidden. Therefore, it is called as prakasha svabhavaha. Evam bhuta sattva guna pradhana mayayam pratiphalita chaitanyabhasa rupeshwarasya svavishaye vishyantareva na eva avaranam sambhavati. Naiva avaranam sambhavati. Avarana is not possible for this kind of Ishvara where there is so much of prakasha. The ajnana avarana, which is tamarupa, that is not possible. तमा इज ऑल्सो डार्कनेस. डार्कनेस के नॉट सर्वाइव द प्रकाश इज सफिशियंट. एवं भूत सत्व गुण प्रधान माया. इन दैट काइंड ऑफ माया देर इज अ प्रतिफलित चैतन्य आभास रूप ईश्वर. दैट इज ईश्वर स्व विषय विषयांतरे वेदर रिगार्डिंग हिज ओन स्वरूप. ईश्वर डज नॉट हैव एनी आवरण. विषयांतरे वेदर इट इज प्रपंच विषय जीव विषय हिट हैज नो आवरण. दैट इज वाई सर्व साक्षी भूत अंतर्यामी स्टेज इन ईच एंड एवरी वन एंड इज अ नियंता इज अ प्रेरक टू एवरी वन. ही नोज ईच एंड एवरी थिंग दैट गोज ऑन सामान्यतया विशेषतया च. ज्ञानी ज्ञानी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड सर्वज्ञ. सर्वज्ञ सर्ववित इज ईश्वर. सर्वज्ञ इज ज्ञानी. इफ यू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन सर्वज्ञ एंड सर्ववित व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस. सामान्यतया सर्वं जानाति इति सर्वज्ञः. विशेषतया सर्वं जानाति इति सर्ववित. ज्ञानी अनलेस ही हैज सिद्धि डज नॉट नो विशेषतया नो सामान्यतया. यस्य ज्ञानेन सर्वं ज्ञातं भवति. ही नोज दैट तत्व ब्रह्म तत्व बाय नोइंग विच एवरीथिंग बिकम्स नोन मीनिंग एज वेल नोन नॉट इन डिटेल अनलेस वन हैज सिद्धिस. सिद्धिस आर अ डिफरेंट मैटर. दे हैव नो प्लेस इन उपनिषद पर से. सो दैट्स द ईश्वर हु कैनॉट हैव आवरण. तस्मात् ईश्वर नित्य मुक्त सर्वज्ञश्च भवति. We'll stop here. This is the reason the Ishvara is Nitya Mukta and Sarvajna also. We'll continue with the rest. We'll finish this particular avarta and then we'll go to the Tippana where other types, other philosophers' definitions of Ishvara are given. Sukha Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Namulpayo. अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेर दृक्यत्व निर्गुणं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परम तदेव अनुत्तमं इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. ओम तत्सत्. नमस्ते.
हरि ओम.
हरि ओम.